Gentlemen, welcome back to the Manchor. For today's video, we're going to be talking about what today's modern men really need. So if you are new here, the Manchor is a community that is built for men that are digging to their core to find out who it is that they really are, what it is that they really want to become. Please consider subscribing and help us build a community to improve the future of men. We cover three topics here at the Manchor, that is masculinity, health, and relationships. So again, today's video is going to be about what modern men really need. And this topic kind of came up to me last week while I was at work. And a gentleman that I work with and know quite well came over and, you know, we were kind of shooting the shit. We were, you know, talking back and forth and, you know, kind of said some derogatory negative comments towards me, and I know the guy, so it's not really that big of a deal. But you know, it kind of got me thinking about really, you know, how much of that actually goes on, whether that be in your friendships, in the locker room, or, you know, at the bar or at work, wherever it may be, at the gym. You know, I think we kind of tend to underestimate the power of what, you know, derogatory or playful comments can be. And, you know, in my personal opinion, had I not known this guy, if it hadn't been, you know, something where, you know, I trusted that it didn't come from a negative place, I think even as a defense mechanism, people kind of tend to throw out those derogatory or negative comments to, you know, try to diminish somebody else because they're either jealous of them or they don't feel as good about themselves, but they put those things out there as defense mechanisms. And I just don't think that any man today fucking needs that. You know, it's hard enough to navigate the world as a leader in business and in life, in your health and in relationships, and just, you know, it's hard enough for a guy to figure out who he is, what he really wants, where he's going, and, you know, to avoid temptation, to avoid distraction, to make sure that he stays on that and believes enough in himself. You know, again, I really got to thinking about the topic, and I just don't think that guys really need shit like that. You know, I think there's a time and a place for it. And I certainly have a lot of, you know, buddies of mine that, you know, it seems like the worse we are to each other, that's kind of the same level of friendship that we have. So what I mean by that is, you know, if they were nice to me, I would raise concern. But because, you know, we take jabs at each other and, you know, we kind of tend to take shots at each other's jugulars, and we're fucking ruthless to each other sometimes. I mean, just brutal. That's actually indicative of being a closer friend to the group or to that person individually. But, you know, I guess I just... it got me thinking about, you know, how much other stuff that men are dealing with, not only just in life, but just, you know, even modern men today. We have a lot of distractions, a lot of things coming at us. We have a lot of temptations. We have a lot of advice coming at us about, you know, who it is that we should be, where it is that we should be going, you know, how we should be approaching our business, or how we should be approaching relationships, how we should be as a boyfriend or as a husband. And all of that is a distraction, and all of it's temptation and ignorance to an internal voice that men should always listen to, which is the one that they have of themselves. You know, I think that, again, it's really about building, just like this channel is, it's about building community for men. To be honest with you, I'm going to be setting up some meetings here with mentors in my own community, because apart from doing, you know, building an online community, with this channel, I want to be able to offer a resource to my own community for men to be able to go to. I live in Nebraska, and, you know, right now, if I go out and I search for men's groups in the area that I live, there is men's groups, but they're not really places that I would want to go. You know, there's like Alcohol Anonymous groups, and there's, you know, Narcotics Anonymous, and those are important. That's kind of separate from what I'm talking about here. The only thing that was as close as to what I'm thinking about or what my vision is a men's group that is like a men's support group that's really kind of at a church. It's more religious based. And I really think, you know, it's none of my business what religion or sect that you choose. That's your choice. That's what you want. I think that really scares a lot of people away. And I'm not inclined to go to, you know, a support group for men, especially if it's in a religion that is separate from my own. So those are the only available resources that we have here where I live. And it might be more prominent more out on the coast, but there's nowhere for men to be able to go, you know, be around other like-minded and going through the same shit and, you know, needing to take charge of their own life, men that they really need to be. You know, men need community. We need tribe. We need support. We need a place to be able to go to work through issues, whether that be for, you know, especially for mental health. You know, I think a lot of things that men are going through is a direct reflection of just how much stuff that they're repressing and not able to exercise and get out of because of the lack of, you know, resources, be it community or online or otherwise, for men, you know, to be able to work through those things. And, you know, if you have mental issues, if men have emotional, we all have our own baggage. We all come with baggage, you know, problems is a sign of life. If there's nowhere to go to be able to handle those things, then what happens is, you know, that tends to come out. I've said it before, those dogs got to get out, and they're going to come out in the form of addictions. You know, whether it be addictions to work, alcohol, narcotics, you know, strippers, coke, you know, maybe it's food, it's just gambling, you know, the list goes on and on. Or maybe it's even exercising. It could even, you know, be a, like somewhat of a healthy or viewed as a healthy addiction. But at the end of the day, it's still an addiction. And again, without a place to be able to go and work through those things to let the guy know that he's okay, that he's not the only one going through this. That's a lot of time what most of the guys need is just, oh, fuck, okay, I'm not the only one who's dealt with this, who's experienced this, who sees it the same way, who feels the same way. I think it really opens guys' eyes up when they see, okay, I'm surrounded by a group of people who get where I'm coming from, who understand that these are the issues that we are contending with, who understand that, you know, this is what I'm trying to do to get ahead, be better, improve, and, you know, just become an overall better man, a better quality man. Men need a community, a tribe, a supportive place where, you know, they can go and work through their shit and not be condemned, not be called names, not, you know, be told what to do or how to be or how to show up. You know, we have to get right with ourselves before we can even begin to help others. Part of being a good man is being a leader. And being a good leader means that you don't create followers, but you create other leaders. And you can't help other people unless you help yourself. So men need to be able to go to a place and work through their shit in a supportive place and learn how to, you know, channel their inner voice and listen to it and follow it so that they can then turn around and help the next guy behind them. You know, this over time is how men get better, you know, in the long term. I post videos online and, you know, I'm trying to reach a community of men and I want to help you. Like I know the same issues, the temptations, the struggles and the distractions that you go through. And it's not lost on me that you come to YouTube to find advice. And when I didn't have any kind of resources locally or didn't really find a lot of them online, I kind of just had the idea to create the Man Corps just because I wanted a place for guys to be able to go just so that they could get, you know, oh, he knows where I'm coming from. He's been there. Like, he gets this. This is exactly how I see it. I totally understand what he means. And then it doesn't make guys feel like that they're like alienated, that they're so far different from the person next to them because, you know, we're all human. We all have shit that we're going through. We just have to know that, like, there are other people who are dealing with stuff and who want to help, who want to serve. This is how we get better. We don't do it individually. I don't post these videos for me. exclusively. This isn't just about getting me better. This is about building a community and a place where we all can learn. I may be doing the videos, but I'm just as much of a student as anybody watching this, because I fail all the time. I make mistakes. I do stupid shit. I get rejected, and you know, I fall back, or I fall down and I get back up again. And, you know, I just want to be able to create a place, an online resource, through the Manchor, where guys can come and, hey, share advice, tips, tricks. Hey man, I understand what you're going through. You're doing okay. Hey, you know, I would work on this. Just a supportive, like, got your back in your corner place. So that way you can always come back here. You know, a big thing about what guys and what men do is that, you know, they go out in the world and they slay the dragon. You know, that's not as much the case anymore because we work in offices, but you know, we want to be able to come and lick our wounds, or we need a place to be able to go, a sanctuary where it's, we don't have to deal with the pressure and the bullshit. I mean, even from women, like, the worst thing that, you know, in my opinion, that a woman can do is, like, basically a guy's been out slaying the dragon all day, and then he gets home and then, you know, he's been taking care of shit. And then on top of that, you know, he's got to then show up and then, you know, be at his best for her. And she's either real negative, or she tries to tear him down, or she tries to test him and she tries to get real negative, whatever the case may be. That is like the worst, and nothing is more frustrating than that. So if a guy is not right by his own, by himself, and he can't tackle the world on his own, how the fuck is he going to be able to do that and support a family and come home and face his wife or his significant other and his children? I mean, it's just, it's possible, but I don't like the potential of those results. I think that's kind of what we're dealing with now. So I mentioned it a few minutes ago. I'm going to be meeting with a couple of local mentors here, because apart from doing the online community, my vision is to create a place for men to be able to go to here in my own city. And the way I envision it is, you know, not as much like a fitness center, though it would have, you know, a semblance of the same kind of organizational needs and, you know, approach that a fitness center would have. But, you know, it's really a place designed for men. So if they wanted to go and work out, if they wanted to go do yoga, if they wanted to go, you know, meet with a priest, or somebody spiritual, if they wanted to go meet with a counselor, if they needed to see a doctor, you know, if it's to be more mindful, it's to, you know, increase your testosterone, if it's to, you know, lose a few pounds, if it's to, you know, help out with your anxiety or your stress levels, or, you know, some emotional stress that you're dealing with. I want a place for guys to be able to go and do that, and then meet and commiserate with each other. And you could maybe find people that are like that in fitness centers now, but I want it to be tailored for men. There's nothing like this. And, you know, my goal is for there to be, you know, obviously the online resource here through the Manchor, but also, you know, in community. So, you know, if you're watching this and you want to know how to become better, how to become a better leader, you know, lead the group. So, you know, be the guy that's gathering people and building the community in wherever you live, in whatever city that you live. Or, you know, encourage people to come together under your recommendation, or under your strategy, or like kind of under your plan or your guidance. That's gonna, you know, not only help to see you in a better light, but it's gonna make you feel like a more confident, certain man, because you're leading other men. You're at least doing your fucking part, instead of just kind of, you know, waiting around like a tumbleweed. You're taking action. You're actually, you know, trying to move things forward. You want to be better, and you care enough about the, you know, the future of the world that your kids are going to grow up into, and the men around you, that you're going to actually take action and bring men together. So I would encourage you to do that. That's what I'm going to try and do. Meeting with a few different mentors here. I don't know where it will go, but you know, the fact is that I have a vision, and I feel very compelled and very mission driven. I've always felt very maybe a little bit obsessed with my own health and masculinity and my relationships. Those are those are the three topics here. And I want a place for men to be able to go and you know, learn how to become their best, optimize and get in good shape, physically and mentally, and you know, learn from leaders and men who have been in their shoes, older, younger. I mean, we're talking kind of 18 to 35 here. And over time, if enough of these communities get started, there's no way that men can't get better if they're gathering together like they always once did in tribes. Before we saw all started working in offices, many of the boys would go and work out on the farms. Before the Industrial Revolution, they would go out and work on their farms. And who was out on the farms all day? I mean, this is all day, like all week. This is just what they did. Who was out on the farms? Well, of course, their father was out there. Their grandparents or their grandfather was out there. Maybe a great-grandfather, their uncles. It was all the men. Well, that's a lot of community. That's a lot of time spent with men, leading and bringing together and protecting the farm and raising the crop and raising the animals and just generally having their shit together. That's where we came from. Now, you know, we totally live in a different area where, again, after the Industrial Revolution, you know, we now have a lot of technology that runs everything. So we sit in cushy desk jobs, which I'm one of those people. But, and we grow up in single family households. Men are less present as fathers. So we have a lot of issues, and I think that men need to be able to go and share their story, deal with their shit, and learn how to become better together. So I challenge you to do that wherever you live, and if you have any ideas, tips, or things that you want to share, please do add them. I do love hearing from each and every one of you, so please do share your feedback. I'm always grateful to hear what your thoughts are and what your journey is. But that's all I have for today. So please do like the video, share the video, and please do share the channel with anybody that you think would be a good contributor or would value the content here at the Manchor. I have to run, fellas, but it's always a pleasure. Again, build community, build a tribe for men, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Cheers.